PLT, APU start, and heater reconfig complete.
Copy.
PLS is go for PERT sequence 4.
The launch team has terminated liquid oxygen replenish to the external tank and is now initializing LOX drainback. T-minus 3 minutes, 14 seconds and counting.
TLS is go for ETLO2 pressurization.
Final pressurization of the external tank's liquid oxygen tank is underway.
PLT, clear caution warning memory. Verify no unexpected errors.
That's Edward. OTC, caution warning clear. No unexpected errors.
Copy. And Discovery, close and lock your visors and initiate O2 flow.
That's in work.
The gaseous oxygen vent hood is slowly being retracted away from the top of the external tank.
TLS is go for ETLH2 pressurization.
Liquid hydrogen replenish on the external tank is now being terminated. T minus 1 minute, 30 seconds. T-minus 1 minute and counting.
Let's just go for auto sequence start.
25.
And we have a go for auto sequence start. Discovery's onboard computers have primary control of all the vehicle's critical functions.
15.
12. 10.
Let's just go for main engine start.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And boost recognition and liftoff of Space Shuttle Discovery, taking the space station to full power for full science.
This is Mission Control Houston.
Discovery roll program.
Rock and roll, Discovery.
Discovery's roll maneuver is complete. It is now in a heads-down position on track for its flight to the International Space Station. Discovery flying 365 miles per hour. 1.5 miles in altitude, 7 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center. Discovery's engines are throttling down as the orbiter passes through the area of maximum pressure on the vehicle.
Discovery, go at throttle up.
Discovery, go at throttle up.
The three main engines on board are throttling back up. Now 1 minute, 12 seconds into the flight, Discovery flying at 1,800 miles per hour, 10 miles in altitude, and 11.5 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center. At liftoff, the fully fueled shuttle, boosters, and external tank weighed 4.5 million pounds. The total thrust at launch was 6,425,000 pounds. All systems continue to function well. 3 good main engines, 3 good power-generating fuel cells, and 3 good auxiliary power units for the hydraulic system. We will now stand by for burnout and separation of the solid rocket boosters. Combined, the twin boosters provide 5.3 million pounds of thrust to propel the orbiter toward space. Discovery now flying 3,600 miles per hour, 32 miles in altitude, 43 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center.
Discovery, two-engine TAL.
Two-engine TAL.
Discovery can reach a transoceanic abort landing in the event of a single-engine failure. However, all three main engines are still operating well. Discovery now flying at 4,300 miles per hour, 48 miles in altitude, and 83 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center. Now 3 minutes and 37 seconds into the flight, Discovery continuing on its path to orbit, flying at 5,000 miles per hour, 56 miles in altitude, and 127 miles downrange.
Discovery, negative return.
Discovery copies, negative return.
Discovery is now flying too high and too fast to return to the Kennedy Space Center and the Space Shuttle Landing Facility in the event of an engine failure. 4 minutes 15 seconds into the flight, Discovery flying at 6,000 miles per hour, 62 miles in altitude, and 177 miles downrange.